was born to be a mailman more than 80 years ago. For Donald Grant, his father, had worked for Cobb & Co. He drove the coach for many years and served that company well, carrying the northern mail via Inverell. Darky Grant became a mailman like his father too, learning at an early age the Royal Mail must go through. So when he'd strike a flooded creek, he'd unharness the horse, tie the mail bags on his back and swim the horse across. At times he did the Wimborne Run before he had left school. His teacher used to tell him that was against the rule. Sometimes he'd get a lecture, sometimes he'd get the stick. It didn't stop young Darky though when his old dad was sick. On leaving school he took the job, the run to Warrabah. In the horse and buggy days before the motor car, 3 days a week he worked that run, he really earned his pay. The round trip was 100 miles with 60 gates each way. He also had the mail run from Manila to retreat, with a sulky load of groceries and bread stacked on the seat. And when the old folks speak of him, they all say much the same. He wouldn't stop till after dark, that's how he got his name. When his life is over, when his final race is run, and should St. Peter ask him what work on earth he'd done, he'll say, for 37 years I had a mail run, mate, then softly curse beneath his breath, not another bloody gate. He was born to be a mailman more than 80 years ago, for Donald Grant, his father, had worked for Cobb & Co. And when the old folks speak of Darky, they all say the same. He wouldn't stop till after dark, that's how he got his name.